Hello students, let us take some problems on the topic of friction. We will start with the first problem. I am marking this question, question number 1. Let's read what is given here. A body weighing 200 Newton is just on the point of moving up the plane by a force of 40 Newton acting parallel and up the plane, full stop. Find coefficient of friction if inclination of the plane is 15 degree to horizontal. Now this is the question which we have in front of us. Based on whatever is given in the question, we would first be writing the data and then we would go on to solve the problem. So let us start solving this problem by writing the data first. We are into question number 1. Let us see what is given here. A body weighing 200 Newton, that is the weight of the body, is just on the point of moving up the plane by a force of 40 Newton. So the applied force P is equal to 40 Newton. Then find coefficient of friction if inclination of the plane is 15 degree to horizontal. The meaning is, in this question they have given us inclination of the plane, which is 15 degree to horizontal. Now based on this condition, I would be drawing a diagram here. Here I am having a plane inclined at 15 degree as given in the problem. Now over this plane there is a body kept which has a weight of 200 Newton. So I have to show a body here, which I would be showing that in the form of a block. This body is having a weight of 200 Newton. That weight would be acting vertically downwards. That is 200 Newton. Next, they have also given us that force 40 Newton is moving the body in the upward direction. That is, a body of weighing 200 Newton is just on the point of moving up the plane by a force of 40 Newton. Means here I am having a force of 40 Newton which is moving the block in the upward direction. Now, here is the diagram which we have in the problem. They are telling us to calculate, find coefficient of friction. So the question is, we need to know how much is the value of mu, that is coefficient of friction between the inclined surface and the block. So now let us start solving this question. I'll write the solution here. Now, since they have given us this block, we need to find out how many forces are acting on the block. If we can see from the diagram, weight is acting vertically downwards. So this weight, which is acting vertically downwards, would be resolved into two components. That is, one component will be along the plane and the other component would be perpendicular to the plane. If I can show you all the resolution, that is splitting the weight into two components, it would be like this. So here I have two components of weight 200 Newton. The inclination with vertical is 15 degree. So here the horizontal component would be 200 sine 15 degree. Vertical component would be 200 cos 15 degree. Now as we know, here we have two components of weight. Because of 200 cos 15 degree, that weight 200 cos 15, this component is acting perpendicular to the surface. Since this component is perpendicular here to the surface, this would be pressing the block against the surface, and because of that there would be normal reaction perpendicular to the surface. So I can say that this is Rn, normal reaction acting vertically upwards. Now after all these forces, as we can see that the motion of the block is upward because of 40 Newton force, the block would be moving in the upward direction. So here I have motion which is up the block. Now opposite to motion there has to be frictional force. So frictional force would be opposite to motion. This F is equal to mu into Rn is my frictional force, and it is opposite to the direction of motion as can be seen here. Now when we have resolved all these forces, we would be going on for the calculation of mu. So how to start this? First I'll say that we would be considering this block in limiting equilibrium. I'll say that consider the block in limiting equilibrium. When we are considering the block in limiting equilibrium, it is very much clear that the block is just on the point of moving up. So I'll say that after that, resolving forces parallel to the plane, therefore resolving forces parallel to the plane, I would write down first summation of fx is equal to 0, where all my upward forces along the plane would be treated positive. All forces which are downward in the direction parallel to the plane, that would be treated as negative. So here in this diagram, if I see 40 Newton is acting up the plane, so it should be taken positive. 200 sine 15 is acting towards downward direction, so it has to be taken negative. F, that is a frictional force, it is also acting in the downward direction, so it has to be taken negative. So I'll write down directly minus mu into Rn is equal to 0. Therefore I will be keeping mu into Rn on one side, that is I would be shifting it to the right side, and here I have 40 minus 200 sine 15 degree. After this I can say that therefore mu will be equal to, therefore mu is equal to this combined value of 40 minus 200 sine 15, that comes out to be 11.76 divided by normal reaction. I will keep this as my first equation. That is, once I get the value of normal reaction, I will put it in equation number 1 and get the answer of mu. After this, I will write down also resolving forces perpendicular to the plane, that is summation of Fy is equal to 0, where all forces perpendicular to the plane in the upward direction are positive, and all forces which are perpendicular to the plane acting in downward direction are negative. So now I can say that if I look into this diagram, I have Rn which is perpendicular and acting upward as positive. I have 200 cos 15 which is acting downward, and as we can see we have just two forces which are perpendicular to the plane. So here I have minus 200 cos 15 degree, that's equal to 0. If I calculate this, I would be getting my answer of Rn that comes out to be, it is, you can say directly, I would be shifting first 200 cos 15 onto the other side. Now, I will say that put Rn in equation number 1. Therefore, mu is equal to 11.76 divided by 200 cos 15 degree. So, therefore, my answer of mu that comes out to be 0.06. That is my answer of coefficient of friction. And if we look into this problem, they were telling us to get the coefficient of friction between the block and this inclined plane. The answer is 0.06. With this, we complete the question.